It's your girl, Shay.
Let's go.
Lake Charles raised, Nashville, man.
Let's go, let's go.
He don't just want one. Said he gotta have
three.
He ain't got no time
for me. Let's go, y'all, come on.
So what you think I'm supposed to do?
Let's go, let's go, let's go. What's up, Miss Courtney?
And be a fool. Said he was gonna call.
What's up, Dale?
On his way home, yes he did.
Nicole's nail, let's go. What's up, Karen? No matter what I do, they say we won't do right. What's up, Mo Better? Let's go, out of favors. Yeah, let's go, let's go, let's go.
About to catch another
flight. Yeah, let's go, let's go.
And I'm living my best thing.
Let's go, let's go.
This ain't no pity party. Too late for pay, I'm sorry. You can't keep treating me like I'm just anybody.
Let's go, y'all. Come on. Welcome to the Blue Table Talk for men and women. Let's go. Let's go, let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go, TikTok. Let's go. Miss Vanessa is in the building.
This ain't no pity party. Boy, I still think you're sorry.
Let's go, y'all. Come on. We're going to have a good talk tonight.
This ain't no pity party.
Let's go. Let's go.
Boy, I still think you're sorry.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Good evening, everybody. Hope everybody is doing all right. What's up, Sneak? What's up, Mo Better? I hope you're feeling Mo Better. How's everybody doing tonight? Hey, Coach.
No, I'm good.
I'm still jamming. Okay. You stopped me mid.
Yeah. Hey, what'd you say? Come on, Sam. Good evening, everybody. Hope everybody's doing fine. We got a good topic tonight, and it's going to be a great conversation. And I got three of the most wonderful people on TikTok, the best people on TikTok in this live right now. So, Sneak, we're going to let you go last. We're going to let Mo go first, Coach Anger. Then you tell everybody how's your week been and how's your mental. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Yeah, my week is like a slow naked ass slide down a razor blade into a pool of alcohol. But you know what? We just gonna make this shit work.
Woo!
We gonna make it work.
It's in the universe.
Man, yes. Hey.
It's like Pluto retrograde tomorrow.
Hey, look.
I had a homeboy's daddy tell me when I was a kid. He was a preacher. He said, "You know, sometimes in life, sometimes you the bug, sometimes you the windshield." This week I'm the bug, but hey, we gonna make it work.
Well, y'all, let's give us some love, Sneak. Give us some love, Sneak.
It's gonna be all right. It's gonna be all right.
It's going to be like, keep your head up. Keep your head up. That's what old Tupac said, right?
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Come on, Coach Angel. How you doing?
Lord have mercy. My brain is scrambled. It's scrambled. Work has been a shit show for the last 3 weeks.
Okay.
And I got another staff member out that I'm covering for till Tuesday. As if I needed more to do.
All right.
And house hunting. So I got some bad news. House is on contract and it's not my contract.
Okay. Hey, DJ Hendog. Okay.
Yeah. So, but I did do, so I'm still hunting. But finals was yesterday that I had to turn in. I have A's in both classes.
Oh, good. There it is.
It's been rough. It has been rough. And this, so coming May 16th through July 30th, I might miss some time with my family here.
Okay.
My loves, because I have permission from the dean to do three classes, three law classes in 6 weeks.
Okay. Awesome. So
it's expedited and there's lots of work. I'm hoping to be able to manage it so that Wednesdays are free, at least for an hour. But we'll see.
Okay, we'll see. Listen. Well, Sneak. Hey, Sneak, I want to dedicate, before you tell us your mental, I want to dedicate this song to these two angels real quick. Y'all ready? I'm going to see if y'all know this song. I'm going to see if you know this song.
Oh, Lord.
Right. I want to see if you know it. We're dedicating this to everybody that feel like Mo and Angel. Here we go.
It might seem crazy, but I'm saying. Sunshine, she's here. You can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon. I can throw his face.
His phone's ringing.
Oh, dang. Oh, okay. Someone probably called him. Doing a good one.
I was about to hit the lick with my lip sync because this is my shit.
Right.
He gonna have to run it back. He's gonna have to run it back. It's my time to shine.
I know that. Run that back, DJ. Run that back.
You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
Look, why is he frozen like this? Somebody needs to screenshot that shit. Look.
Oh, he's back.
Damn, he's back.
You were frozen. You have phone calls or something?
I froze on y'all.
Absolutely.
You were like this.
We didn't catch none of that after like the first.
Yeah, you got to run that back, DJ. Run that back.
Yeah, let me see. I was doing let me my lip sync shit. I was in the zone. I was finally.
Sunshine, she's here. You can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon. I could go to space.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Hey, Summer.
I don't care, baby, by the way. Because I'm from alone. If you feel like a room without a roof. Because I'm from alone. If you feel like happiness is the truth. Because I'm happy alone. If you know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy alone.
Hey, what's up, sweet Snell? What's up, Lynn? Long time no see. Y'all put in the chat what makes you happy. What you happy about tonight? Put it in the chat. What makes you happy tonight? Put it in the chat. What makes you happy tonight? Put it in the chat. All right, Sneaky. How you doing, Sneak?
Well, I'm doing good, man. I'm about, I'll give myself like a 85, 90. It's been an interesting week. I've been in a, they've gone whole hog on this taking over thing. So I've been in a class with some of the leaders of the organization, learning, certifying to be an instructor in crisis management and de-escalation. That's the thing right now. And then after that, you know, I'm just waiting for one guy to go and other things to happen. So they, it's interesting. It's interesting.
Hey, TK. Hey, TK. Okay. So, give us a percentage. How will your responsibilities increase? Give us a percent. I know you say your salary is going to quadruple, but as far as responsibilities, give us a number.
Okay. Well, in regards to salary, I'm going to even ask for, I'm asking for more because of the change. The amount of risk and responsibility that my boss has now is going to multiply by 5 because of some things that we're bringing in, which brings inherent risk and more responsibility.
Understand.
And you're gonna pay for that. Okay. So if he's getting a certain amount of money for what he's doing at this stage, and now we're expanding and I'm supposed to take on more responsibility, more risk, you're going to expand that paycheck a little bit more. All right. If he's been doing this for years at this level and you want to increase the level, then you're going to increase the income. And that's just the way it's going to be.
Okay. I like that. Come on, Mo.
HR compensation negotiator extraordinaire here. Questions, if I may.
Sure.
So number one, do you know the salary of the person that you're replacing?
Yes, to the penny.
Perfect. Do you know what their budget trajectory into the next 2 budget cycles is?
All right, we specifically don't have a budget, but if the facility wants something because of our section to do something or increase something, then the section that wants it has to fund it. Okay. Now we are talking about, I am talking about getting my own budget, which is going to be in my negotiation. So whatever size of money that I'm going to ask for, probably about $100,000, I'll get that.
You're talking about the shit that you get so you can leverage in your job. Fuck that. I'm talking about whoever that's going to pay you what they have available.
Right. So,
two-pronged strategy, because for the type of increase that you're talking about, I'm anticipating pushback.
Oh, there is going to be no pushback. They've already told me, dude, we want you, and they're probably going to give you an offer you can't refuse.
So here's a little alternative, especially if they promised the butter on your bread. Mm. Okay.
Both sides.
Right. Right. Give me this number in salary.
Mm.
Because you need me more than I need you, I'm gonna need this non-refundable upfront bonus on the day of my start in this
new sign on bonus.
Yeah, and I like my steaks medium well.
Well, I'll give that some thought, because see, they just gave the overall organization raises, everybody. They went from one amount of money, and I'm not talking about 25 cents an hour, 50 cents. So that just happened in a new negotiation.
No, respectfully, Sneaky,
mm.
I don't give a fuck. Because here's the thing.
Mm.
For what they need for you to do, the motherfucker that's doing it is leaving. There's not another clear, apparent motherfucker other than you to do it.
So this is true.
That shit don't mean nothing. Name you. And as somebody that has sat in the upper C suites doing these kind of, you know, trajectories and whatever, there's some extra gravy to put on your rice.
Oh, I got you. The worst thing they can do is say no.
That's right. Exactly. I tell people that every single day, Sneaky. Right.
Yeah. But all of that's going to come in once I get the offer letter. Now I'm be like, okay, this is what you're offering, but this is what I require. I'm just waiting on the offer letter.
I wouldn't even wait for the offer letter, the initial offer letter, because it's already, these are already warm conversations that you're having.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, you doing a mediocre Wahite man thing. No. You got to go, listen, you go in like 45. You like, listen, Chad,
hey, I hope y'all taking notes on human resources negotiation. I hope y'all taking notes. See, you can't get all this anywhere else but the Blue Table Talk for men and women.
That's right.
You're going to say, hey, Chad, yeah, so
I'm realize I'm Wahite too, right?
No, you're not. Anyway. Hey, 0.04%, okay? 0.04%.
Look, did you just try to FICO your way out of? Oh, anyway, so you're like, Chad, hey, yeah, listen, this is going great. Really excited about the transition. Can't wait to get started. But hey, listen, yeah, so I know we perused Phillips compensation, and you know we're understanding that we're just gonna flip seat those numbers, and I'm just gonna walk into that. But hey, woo.
Hey, top fighter.
Given the way that I have accelerated the training curve, right, and you know, based on the fact that you don't have to go externally or further internally. I think that's worth some additional considerations, right? I think a one-time bonus, we can spitball that at $20,000-$25,000. I think that's worth a conversation, right?
That would be worth the conversation. Absolutely.
You did say you want a boat, right?
How much? That would be the boat.
What she said, based on what Mo said, I would price the high-end boat I want. And that'll be my talking point for a bonus.
That's valuable.
I love the yellow, by the way.
That's valuable.
Mo, thank you, Mo. It's the
nails. Absolutely. That's something I hadn't even thought of. But yeah, thank you for that.
Okay. Well, Coach, y'all send some love out to Coach India. Her allergies are flaring up. And my wife and I have been battling that too. I mean, out of nowhere, you get a headache and that pollen count is off the charts now, y'all. Oh my, it's a real thing. It's a real thing. For real. I'm sending healings for everybody on the panel. Mm-hmm. I'm sending mad love to everybody in the chat. All is well. All is well, y'all. All is well. How we feeling tonight? Well, Sneaky, the question on the table is, if you had a choice, some influencer ask a bunch of ladies, if you were stuck in the woods, would you rather be stuck with a bear or with a man? And ladies, we want to hear from y'all tonight. Me and Sneaky got our opinion, but ladies, let me hear from y'all tonight. What do you think prompted that conversation? And what's the street saying? What's the street saying?
Who's going first?
Who's up?
Ladies, we want to hear from y'all. Would y'all rather be stuck in the woods with a bear or a man?
So let me put this disclaimer.
Get my view and go get some wine. Girl, go take this shot.
So let me put this disclaimer out.
In top flight, I want you in the hot seat.
All men are bad or, you know, violent or whatever. But I will tell you from my own personal experience.
That's what with that. Thank you. Thank you.
Being essayed at 18 months old, at 13 years old, violently at 18 years old by a family member. Both of my marriages, I was cheated on. Every major relationship I have been cheated on. So every man that's been in my life outside of my father, who was meant to protect me and or take care of me or that sort of thing, failed to do so. So for me, I can go in the bear. I can go with the bear because it's predictable. I know exactly what's going to happen. It is predictable. I know that bear is going to beat the hell out of me, eat me, snatch me. What it's going to do, whatever it's going to do. But a man who presents themselves as, you know, a caretaker, I'm going to take care of you. You can trust me. I would never be like that. I would never hurt you, only for them to do it. And like the video you sent me, Doc, look at the statistics. Last year alone,
That's real talk.
Seven women died from bear attacks, but 70 a day died from domestic violence. And that did not include the people at the mall, at the grocery store, walking down the street. It didn't include any of them. For me, it didn't include my stalker, and he was a door-to-door salesperson. He came to my door trying to sell me some home improvement. I never so much as shook that man's hand. But he tricked my youngest son
who was not
at the time to give him my number.
That's a good point, Brown. That's a good point.
So I'm just saying, for in my personal experience, every man who was meant to protect me and or take care of me or presented themselves as, oh, I would never do that, they did so. Every time. So to me, it's almost equally predictable.
Hey, Susan, that's good. Mo, what's your thought? That's personal. That's a testimony. Thank you for that, Coach Angel.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, Amarie covered it from the practical tactical. I'm going to give y'all the spectrum brain response because, you know, I like to keep shit simple. I like to make shit practical. Okay. All right. So a couple of things, off the rip. And listen. And what gets me is it was a dude that asked this question. I'm like, how you gonna ask some shit and then be mad at the responses?
I want to hear me and Sneaky gonna talk because we can't get mad at the stats. We can't get mad at the fact. I cannot get mad at what Coach Angel just laid on the table. I can't get mad at that.
But here's the further thing. Again, spectrum brain. Let's extrapolate and bring the theorem. Let's elevate the theorem.
Okay.
Come on, my nerdy sister.
Baby, the way that I'm sitting here like, these motherfuckers, why you have to ask that question? You get a fucking answer, and you're like, well, no, that ain't practical.
Right. That's what my wife said.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry.
Come on, Mo.
Here's the thing, right? It's an abstract thought work. Exercise.
That's right.
Who theoretically do you feel safer with? The theoretical process of a random man or a fucking animal in the goddamn forest. As soon as women said bears, Every man turned into Steve Irwin, like, crikey, ah, no, you must not understand the nature of the bear.
Stupid, right? We're stupid. We don't know that a bear is going to eat us.
No.
Okay.
Oh, no. It got better. You know how many motherfucking zoologists I discovered on this goddamn map after this question? Hey, let me tell you about the Kodak bear versus the brown bear versus the panda bear.
And wait a minute, let me tell you about the brown bear and the black bear.
Oh my God, damn. I'm like, ooh, this is like the motherfuckers that was like, okay, so welfare do this, Section 8 do that. These motherfuckers are a veritable cornucopia of information. I'm like, wow, this is, that's great. But what?
Koala.
All it boils down to.
In the polar bear. Yeah, don't forget the polar bear.
Bruh, I was like, these motherfuckers.
Hey, man.
Listen, it ain't.
Hey, Carrie.
Y'all need a Honda or Toyota to drive past the point. Y'all are just grabbing bicycles and fucking just scooters. Okay? So
you saying men got in their feelings more?
Not only in their feelings, but here's a couple of things about it. Okay, so if you want to be practical and tactical about it, right? Because they're like, oh, bears attacked it. Okay. Men made protection against bears, but not against men. Because there's bear spray. And then against men, there's what? Mace. But guess what? Men train against mace. So mace really turns into Mace COS in the hospital.
Yeah.
Mace COS laid out on the floor. Mace COS in some kind of other ruin. And it's even to the point that they tell women, hey, yeah, mace probably ain't gonna work because these motherfuckers are trained against it. Use bear spray.
Come on.
Shit.
Yeah,
use bear spray against the men. And then further, for men to just simply get personally offended by the choice of the bear and not walk through, well, why are bitches choosing the bear instead of us? But no, you would rather just simply rail at these bitches. They're stupid because they're choosing the bear.
That's why, this is why we are here, this safe space. This is why we have these men's discussions with you guys. This is why we do it. This is why to ask that very question. So Sneaky, what's your heart saying when you heard this? And the type of man that you are, and you are a gentleman among men, you live in a house full of women, you got one little man to help you now, short round. But what's your heart when you heard that most women chose the bear over being stuck with the man in the woods? What say ye?
My heart didn't say shit. All right? You can't ask the question and then get mad at the answer. It's not about the bear. It's not about the man. It's about the risk. Women are saying the risk of me getting fucked up by a dude is higher than if I hypothetically was in the woods with a freaking bear. I don't see why that's so hard to freaking comprehend. Okay. It didn't hurt my feelings. I was like, oh shit, maybe we should do better. First thing came across my mind.
Sneaky.
You know,
Angel said. Angel said.
And you know what? Bears are fucking easier to talk to because you know what? A bear would not argue with you about your fucking choice of the man of the goddamn. Bears wouldn't sit up and go,
hey, boo boo, I'm smarter than the other.
I'll tell you this. Being an infantry guy, and I spent a whole lot of time in the woods, and I passed a whole lot of wildlife in the woods. A bear is concerned with the safety of its youngins. So if you get around the den, you're probably going to get fucked up. So don't mess with a bear's kids, okay? It's hungry. If it's not fed and you're around, you might be a target of opportunity. But it's not malicious. It doesn't have a temper. Ain't mad at you.
It doesn't have an agenda.
It doesn't have an agenda. A bear is going to do what bears do. But unfortunately, the other side of that coin is men do what men do also. And we do some fucked up shit, okay? I don't see no bears shooting up no schools. I don't see no bears beating on women. I don't see no bears. You see what I'm saying?
Hello.
If the problem is with how if your little raisins got you all pissed off because of the question, then maybe you need to do something to inflate them raisins.
And don't men hunt bears?
Yeah, they do.
My dad did.
In addition to women?
No, meal talk. We know that. We're not talking about all
women. You know what? I hate that. I absolutely hate that. Not all men, not all women. We know that. Stop it, people. No one's saying that. We know that.
So Joker said 3 women per 1,000 violently abuse children. 2 men per 1,000 commit assault. Children choose bear. Thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, because listen, guys, let me recap, because Mill Talk may have come in late. Based on Angel said it in her talk. Okay, Angel said in her talk. Mill Talk said that not all men. I know it's a sweeping generality, and Angel gave a personal testimony. 100% of the time, the men that were supposed to protect her did not do so. Now, go back and watch one of the videos that I do edit. Statistically, in 2020, 7 women in 12 months were killed by a bear. But in the same year, 70 women per month were mishandled by men in a domestic violence setting. So based on what Sneaky said, I'm an engineer, I did statistical analysis. The probability of a woman being mishandled by a man is higher than her risk with a bear. And that was that whole scenario, like Mo said. It's an intellectual exercise. Us men got to do better. We are predators. These women are S8 on a daily basis. My wife cannot even go into the gas station to use the restroom without somebody looking at it. And I've seen it. I watched it. They better not say nothing to her. I watched it.
Right.
Okay? We men are something. I wouldn't date a man for all the tea in China. Go ahead, y'all.
Damn.
Let me throw this in real quick, Mo, before you say this. Let me say this. For the person who said not all men, well, not all women chose the bear. Okay?
So here's the thing with the not all. Okay? And oh, listen, I'm, oh, God, look, let me lift the glasses up so y'all can see my eyes, because
let me put Mel on the hot seat.
If I could just reach one motherfucker tonight with this, I swear.
Just one.
Okay, you ain't got to be like a Lay's potato chip, okay? I don't need multiples. Just one motherfucker with me tonight. Okay, it ain't that it's all men. For women, we have to operate in the spirit of it could be any man.
Yeah.
And I think that men, y'all confuse our spirit of it could be any one of you motherfuckers with it's all of you motherfuckers. That ain't necessarily
that is a good point. Say that again, Mo. That's a good point.
I got you. It's not that it's all of you motherfuckers, it's that it could be any one of you motherfuckers. And so we gotta operate in extreme prejudice. Because it's literally our lives potentially on the goddamn line.
Hello.
It's fine for y'all to go gallivanting and ranting around in the streets and shit. Because, I mean, the worst, okay, yeah, you can get a dust up or whatever, you know.
I'm not worried about me. Now, I don't know about Sneaky, because Sneaky is handsome and sexy. I'm not worried about me getting snatched up by anybody.
Exactly.
I'm not worried about that. But I wouldn't let my wife get in the car and go to the store this time of night. I wouldn't do it.
Dr. Walter Sims and Sneaky do not get in their cars at 10 o'clock at night and go to the fucking 24-hour Walmart and be like, oh my God, I gotta worry about where I'm walking because I don't want to get fucked up coming in and out of the store. Because, you know, it's women out here tonight.
Come on.
They said that shit now. Now time and they fucking like, oh, you gotta watch out, it's late and there's women out here. Hold on. You ain't never, not never day in your life ever conceptualized that shit.
That's a good point.
So that's right. Every one of y'all is
like that, Mo.
Any one of y'all. And
I like that.
And the onus is on us to figure out which one. And if we fuck up and get it wrong, we may not get another shot at another chance to see if we can get it right.
Go ahead, Angel. Then Mel is on the hot seat.
So, hey Mel, hey family. To Mo's point, when I had a stalker in California, so when I left there and I moved clear across country, for the first year that I lived here in North Carolina, I did not leave the house. I did not leave the house because I didn't want to be seen. I didn't want to be followed. I was in a strange place. I literally ordered everything to come to my house, like Bed Bath & Beyond, everything, groceries, CVS prescriptions, you name it, I ordered it and had it.
Well, Angel, not to cut you off, Angel, but to Mo's point, tell them how he became a stalker. To Mo's point, it's not all, it's any. Tell them how he became a stalker.
He was a door-to-door salesperson. He literally came to the door, said, oh, I see you need this and this, and the, you know, and I was a tenant. I was a renter. And I said to him, I'm sorry, I'm just a tenant. Leave your marketing material in the mailbox. And he was like, oh, well, I don't have any marketing material. I said, how are you a door-to-door salesperson and you don't have any marketing material? Mind you, he's got the whole logo and the tag and, you know, he's got his clipboard and everything, but you don't have any marketing material. So he was like, well, let me go check my car. So he goes away for 30 minutes, comes back and says, oh, well, I found one. And I said, well, write your name on it so that you can get credit for it if the landlord wants to do some work with you, what have you. So he puts his name on there, very unique name. So, and that's how I got to checking people's background from that point on. Anyway, so then he says, well, where's your husband? And I said, I don't need one of those. And then he said, well, do you have friends? And I said, I absolutely have friends. He was like, well, can I be your friend? I said, oh, no. I'm not taking any new friend applications right now. I'm not interested. Thank you, but I'm not interested. He flips out, opens his wallet. I'm no buster. Okay, and blah, 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 blah. And mind you, he's a 46-year-old, 5'5" black man. So he's an older man. And he went on and continued on. And I said, no, I don't mean to offend you, but I'm not interested. I'm not dating right now. I'm good. And so he ends up leaving. I go outside. Not 20 minutes later, he came back to the door. Now, mind you, I never shook his hand. I never opened the door. Thank God. Because when I did the background check, he's got 15 pages of criminal activity to include breaking and entering, domestic violence, child sexual abuse under the age of 3. You name it, he had it on there. And he's a door-to-door salesman. I never dated this man. Do you know I couldn't get protection? Do you know that that most police units and state laws prevent me from getting a restraining order to keep from harassing me? Because if I showed y'all the text, matter of fact, when I put it out in May of 2021, on TikTok. So if you scroll through all my stuff and you get to May of 2021, it is still there. I had to blurp out some of the words, otherwise TikTok would not post it. So when you read his text messages to me, I showed a police officer that. Oh, well, you know, did you date him? Was you sleeping with him? No, I didn't.
Good thing you did. Good thing you did.
But I will tell you this much, I could have got a restraining order if I had dated him.
Right.
So you can't get a restraining order without dating them?
Nope. And that is exactly why.
Well, it's not dangerous unless you get with them?
It's exactly why you see these celebrities who have stalkers who end up in their house.
Yep.
They can't do anything about the stalker outside of their perimeter of their house or unless they try to physically attack them. Because this man did not physically try to attack me and that because he did not come into my home, I could not do anything. Hey, but that's the same thing with celebrities. Celebrities can only press charges and or get restraining orders once they cross that barrier.
And wow.
It's ridiculous also, that we are not protected.
Let me add this. So when they're, you know, the emails, the phone calls, police tell you, change your email, change your phone number. You have to completely upend your fucking life behind what this shitball is doing.
Isn't that something?
I had a Domino's pizza guy, and I was 16. Deliver a pizza to my friend's house. I'm 16. Like, grown men, like, what the fuck? Absolutely not, right? He saw me. My friend had a dog. He was scared of dogs or whatever. So I'm just holding the dog because I'm hungry. I want the fucking pizza. Ain't nobody looking at you, okay? It's pepperoni. That's my favorite, okay? Shit.
Give me that pizza.
I hold the dog, but he sees me, gets locked on or whatever, and stalks my friend's house looking for me. She tells me, it's like, you got to say something to this motherfucker because he got to stop being around my house. So he proceeds to start to stalk me. I'm 16.
This man.
Oh, the shit we go through, and y'all talking about, well, you know, but the bears in the forest. Man, shit, give me the forest. Shit.
No, I'm finna say, you should order that pizza from a bear.
Hey, give me lion, tigers, and bears. Look, hold on, girls. Hold on, ladies. Hold on.
He followed me. And then on social media, he would follow me. And as soon as I posted that in May of 2021, do you know it was not hours later, 2 hours later to be exact, that he texted me again and was like, wow. Hey, LOL. And I've never responded to him after the first time because he tricked my youngest into giving my phone number because I was outside. So don't present to me that you are a salesperson and then really what you trying to do. And if I showed y'all the messages, Doc, I think you've seen the messages. It is vulgar. Vulgar.
It's crazy. And I'm telling, my heart goes out to you guys. Mel is on the hot seat. Mel, what's your take, man or bear?
Well, that's a hard one. Well, because the part is, if you say that the bear mauled the woman, they going to say, oh, well, it is a bear.
That's
what the bear is expected to do. The bad part about the man's standpoint is we live in a society that was geared from the legal system by the man for the man. So, you know, it was geared for him. When she was on her way to go to the East Coast, I was sitting up there. I was one of them looking out for her thing. It's like, where are you at? I'm like, she cannot divulge where she's located.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Cannot divulge. Due to her safety, you cannot divulge where she is. And this went on for a while.
Mm-hmm. Right. Years.
So the part is, first of all, everybody that has male organs aren't men.
Oh, that's that part.
Ooh. You know, and the other part is, you know how people say, your picker could be off? I'm talking about, but a lot of the people that are, like with the internet now, a lot of people utilize the internet as a mask.
Oh, of course. Of course.
So they meet the person and they the nicest person in the world until you get to know them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Present so one way and show out another.
Right. Because the main point is to what Mo said and what Mel is saying, guys, and we've all said pretty much the same thing. Animals move on instinct, but people, men, they have ulterior motives. And again, I love how Mo said it. Not all, but any man could be a predator. Yeah, you know how you're not wearing a t-shirt that's saying, I'm a predator. I just want you. You know, because I was sharing this with a client the other day, somebody that's deceptive, they're not going to lead with that deception. They're going to lead with something that's comfortable. Well, I'm a door-to-door salesman and I'm selling vacuum cleaners today. I see you got dirty floors, which you want a vacuum cleaner, but underneath his vacuum cleaner shirt, he's got a predator t-shirt. The world doesn't lead with what their agenda is. And I love how Mo put it. But I gotta worry about your agenda. I don't know you. But mm-hmm. A lot of times people are attacked by people they do know. I think somebody put that in the chat. I knew my attacker. Okay?
I got a question.
All three.
Another crazy all thing three. About it. Oh, also why we choose the bear is that if the shit do go bad and we gotta say some shit went down, you'll believe we got attacked by a fucking bear. But when we say we got attacked by a man, it's like, well, what'd you have on? Well,
what'd you do?
What'd you do? Well, what'd you have before?
Why was you out
so fucking? How many times did you fucking? How hard was the fucking that you did? It's all of the questions and all of the things. But it's like, I got to take my bear. Holy shit. It automatic pass because it's a bear.
That's so good. That is so good. Mel's got a question for the panel. Go ahead, Mel.
Now, my question is this. If anybody can remember back when you was little, you should go to elementary school, and they had something called show and tell.
Come on.
Mm-hmm. See, because most of the time, what they show you and what they tell you is totally different.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? They show you. They show you they got the winning hand. They just didn't tell you they didn't know how to play spades.
Come on, absolutely. Coach Angel. Come on, Coach Angel. You better not renege. You better not renege. That's so good, man. Let me get Mel off of here. I got somebody else want to be on the hot seat. Thank you, Brother Mel. Mel, Sneaky, we may just vote. We had to vote Mel onto the panel. We may have to just get him on the panel every week, Sneak.
Well, just say bring him on, and I'll be like, I second it.
Okay.
You the boss. You bring him on. I second it.
That'll work. We're going to vote him on to the panel. But Mo, you made a good point, Mo. You made an excellent point. If I get attacked by a bear, everybody in the world will believe me.
Mm-hmm.
But if I get attacked by a man, and that's not, we're not talking about the latest out, and we know all of us got our stuff in our bag, but tonight the ladies, we want to love on them tonight. And I have to, you know, when I hear some of the horror stories, we were at family dinner, Easter dinner, talking about this. And right now, and we finally got our 11-year-old niece, she finally got a cell phone. And my brother-in-law is so super protective. My wife, bless her heart, we are super protective. She's just 11.
Mm-hmm.
And we got eyes on her all over the place. We are doubly cautious about everywhere she goes. My brother-in-law said, if I call you, you better answer on the first ring. Yep. You know?
But you know what? I have to tell you, even with all of the overprotections, and I started laughing because obviously, you know, my ass is old, so I started with the internet back in the dial-up days.
Wait a minute, you got mail.
Right.
Yep.
And listen, if you want to be nasty back then, you had to be dedicated, okay? Because you know how long it takes a goddamn nasty picture to download? You know how dedicated you are to be away for some ass.
Oh, I remember the line by
line. She said dial-up internet. I'm before internet existed old. You know what I'm saying? I'm beeper old.
Me too.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm gonna tell on myself. My uncle, he's not watching. My uncle, and I was telling this to my wife. My uncle had a magazine collection.
Mm-hmm.
We stumble across it.
Mm-hmm.
And then
the pages stuck together. Some of the pages stuck together. Anyway, the bear does not hide the fact that he's an omnivore. You know it eats freaking vegetables and meat.
Yep.
A man, if he's not an honest one, and everyone got some of that bullshit in him, a man can misrepresent, he can lie, he can do whatever, especially on the internet nowadays.
He's really good at it.
Wait,
hold up, think about this. Has there ever been a time, have you seen any story, any female bear Reese Tisa that was talking about a male bear Legion?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
I just can't get over the fact.
I was in the woods and I ran up on a bear, but the bear acted like he wasn't a bear. He acted like he was probably a pig. He wasn't a bear.
Doc. It's like, yeah, you know, I met this motherfucker. He said his name was Winnie and he had a honey or whatever. But then I went back to his house. And he had shit. It was just like, you know, it was this little elephant hanging out at his house, and I understand why he was friends
and I was expecting to eat honey, and he feeding me some broccoli and some carrots and some cauliflower.
No, you're expecting Minnie the Pooh, but you got Smokey the Bear.
Yeah, hit it. Give us some love, Sneaky. Give us some love.
There you go, man. It ain't right.
Okay, ladies, this begs the next question, and y'all are looking at my notes. This begs the next question then.
There you go, man.
So when we call y'all the B word because y'all are not nice, you ain't smiling, you look one way, you don't pay us no attention, you act like an ice queen, you don't flirt, you don't wear nothing out of the way, you smell like Old Spice and not Chanel number 5, and we call y'all the B word. But does this beg the question, you have to act like that to keep us to act halfway decent?
I mean, see, I don't get that whole thing.
So that we can assess you and try to figure out if you are going to be the predator that you've been programmed that you potentially could be. Potentially.
Okay. You know what's funny about that is because I literally, and I could walk into my fucking bathroom right now. I got Irish Spring and fucking Axe as my body wash. I do that shit on purpose. Because I don't want to be fucking, but I want to smell like you. I don't want that attraction shit. Okay, I want you to be like, damn, bro. I know, right, bro?
But they call it.
One thing about what you said though that initially pissed me the fuck off. I ain't gonna hold you.
Okay.
But that y'all don't flirt. Who the fuck owes you a flirt, a smile, a look, a glance, or any kind? What?
Right.
Because we Tarzan, you Jane, you supposed to haul that up.
No.
That shit with men, you see long hair, titties, and ass. It's like, oh, there's got to be teeth with it. No, the fuck it don't. Why do men, not y'all?
It's called a game for a reason.
Why do men feel entitled to the placation of their personal feelings based on the emotive expression of miscellaneous women? I can understand bitches you know and bitches you support and whatever, but miscellaneous women? Why?
Because our egos are that big, though. You're supposed to holler at your boy.
But I don't get that.
No ego that big, but
I don't get that. Like, running game, trying to chill, trying to talk to, trying to holler, whatever you want to call it, trying to holler, trying to run game. Hey, how you doing? I think you're attractive. You like to go out, blah blah blah. You got to be prepared for the yes and the no. If you get the no, all right. Well, I guess I didn't stack up to that one. Next, keep it moving.
This ain't even about the women they want to ask out or they want to holler at. They want pleasantries, period. They have no intentions of trying to approach the woman for any type of interaction, but they still expect the pleasantries.
Right. See, I used to be a person that would compliment often. All right. Hey, how you doing? That's a nice dress you have on. Wow, your nails look nice. Random person, grocery store, freaking wherever I'm at, I would compliment. Okay. I don't do it so much anymore because that turns into, who the hell are you talking to? I got a man. Oh, shit. I was just trying to tell you I liked your shoes.
I'll want you, man.
You know what I'm saying? But I don't do that anymore. There's things you don't do, things you can't do.
Sneaky, let me just tell you, I'm 50 years old, and I can tell you every single man I have met in the last 6.5 years is like, oh, I'm sure people flirt with you all the time. No, they don't. Not even in the grocery store. No, they don't.
See, but sometimes a compliment isn't a flirt. Sometimes a compliment's just a compliment.
Right. Mm-hmm. Hey, stress. But again, it's societal, right? It's society, right? And it's to the point what I asked a few moments ago, and the ladies have been so conditioned, like Mo said, I'm going to wear Irish Spring because if me and you hanging out with and she smell like Irish Spring, we're not going to think twice. Look at her. She smell like us. We sitting there smoking cigar, drinking brandy, and she got a cigar and she drinking brandy with us. Oh, she just one of the fellas. So she like, okay, y'all good, you know, y'all good. But then she starts smelling good. And the next time we hanging out at the bar, we're like, Mo.
Well, I just hate that in this day and age, women can't just women. Now they got to prepare. You know what I'm saying? I hate that. You just can't go out and enjoy your day and think everything's going to be all right, minding you. Now you got to prepare. What if a dude does this? What if a dude does that? What if a dude does this instead of, I don't know, back when I was coming up, you know, you just did. Hey, how you doing? That's a nice dress. Yeah, thank you.
Y'all give your business. Give it up to Yella. He's in here.
Yella.
We talked about that 3 weeks ago. He's working now. He's working now. He's a courier. Yellow. What exactly is your job?
You got me working.
But he's on a break right now, so we want to give some love to Yellow. We said it a few weeks ago. He's got a new job. He's working now during the evening, so we just want to give a shout out. Clam some play. Give him some love, Yellow.
Man, I wish Yellow come to me. Happy belated birthday, man. I hope everything's good for you. Love you to death, my friend.
Okay, this goes out to Yellow, y'all. This is the clean version. This goes out to Yellow, y'all.
It's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a party like it's
hey,
your
bro.
Birthday.
Y'all tap that screen. We want 15,000 hearts.
Bottle full of bug, mama, I got what you need. You need to fill
we love you, Yellow.
So come give me a hug. If you ain't getting rough, you can find me.
What's up, tequila?
Bottle full of bug, mama, I got what you need. You need to fill the bars. I'm in the so come give me a hug in the
world. Hey, Yellow, I know you will have a lot to say about this discussion tonight, a man or a bear, but the ladies have very well made their point. And we need a t-shirt. I'm not worried about all men, but it could be any man. It's not all men, but it could be any man. I love that, Mo. I'm gonna quote you the first time. The first time I'm gonna quote you, the second time I'm gonna say this is what I say.
Listen, drives for via van service.
That's awesome. Nice. Awesome, Yellow.
You and Dr. Julio is using my men are homosocial heterosexual. He even took that one. So
that's
those as you see fit, but
hey, wild horse.
We need t-shirts for real. We need t-shirts. Well, okay, ladies, let me ask you this, and this is for our edification as men. You're talking to the fella. So how do you know it's okay?
Bible says choose the bear.
Okay. All right. That's a chapter verse somewhere. I say this is all about the Bible. Okay. How do y'all know it's safe? How do y'all know it's safe to kind of let your guard down, so to speak, around certain men? Or do you ever let your guard down?
Do so at your
okay.
I've been single 6 years. It is very hard to even trust anybody. You know, when you have such a mistrust so deeply ingrained in infancy, right? 18 months old to on up, it's very difficult for me to even let people close to me.
Right.
It's hard to let my guard down when meeting somebody to see how if they really are okay or not okay. And almost instantly, as soon as I get that first even little yellow flag, I'm like, I'm out. Let me just cut this off at the pass.
Okay.
So for me, it's different but the same. So because I'm diagnosed on the autism spectrum, there are certain social cues and different just feeling dynamics that just don't click for me.
Right.
Like, you know, if you're looking for somebody to be all the mushy-gushy, nope, I ain't got it. I ain't never felt
it. It's rough, y'all. Hey, welcome in, everybody. Thank you if you're new here, give us a purple heart. If it's your first time picking out the blue paper talk for
Mel
me
just spoke
and
bars.
Our sisters. Huh?
Mel just spoke bars. Look what he said.
Yeah, guard comes down when being secure is proven, not just spoken.
I love
that.
Yeah,
absolutely.
That's good, Mel.
I definitely.
Well, I hate that that's happened to you ladies that put you in that position. But I also hate that it's men that put you there, and men just got to accept the fact that we are sometimes our worst enemy. Not just your worst enemy, but we are our own worst enemy.
Yeah, I mean, just the stuff that, I mean, and I'm sure some of y'all, and my wife talked about this working in corporate America, you just get numb to it on a daily basis. How many times are y'all, somebody, oh, girl, you wearing that. Somebody's going to say something out of the way to y'all on a daily basis. You got to get numb to it, you know? Y'all are, like Mo said, we can go out right now. It is 10 o'clock at night, 9 o'clock at night. We can go to Waffle House right now and chill and stay all night if we want to. But y'all can't afford that. Y'all can't do that. You can't go out willy-nilly.
Even my sons, who are 20 years old, his 20 years old, does not allow me to go out by myself after dark.
Hey, you
not to the gas station, not to the grocery store, nowhere.
Okay, well, ain't nobody here to tell me not to do shit. So.
You know, I mean, just thinking about that, that would be so heavy of a burden to bear, so laborious. Every time you walk out, someone's looking at your butt. Wanting to see if they can, looking at this, want to touch you, want to holler at you, you know, tugging. That would.
So check this out, Sneaky. So for large swaths of my life, I've absolutely been told I'm unattractive, the whole thing, blah, blah, blah. Okay, whatever. Bye. So got to a point, self-esteem, confidence, I'm feeling down and that. So, you know, I go to the little store, got my little dress, but, you know, it's, I'm just running out. No makeup, I'm just, you know, because I need to make okra and tomatoes. I ain't got no fucking tomatoes. Okay, fine. Dude tries to holler at me, But the whole experience and everything of it is so uncomfortable, and I'm so like, shit. Like, okay, let's dissect why did this shit happen. Only thing I changed was what the fuck I had on.
Okay.
Yes. I never go to the grocery store like that. So look, you see this camo? Listen, camo shirt, camo pants. You see this? Look, I'm in a bun.
What'd you say? Heaven forbid you wear a sundress, huh?
Look, I'm going in, you know, and you know, where the milk at?
Clue man, you know, I hear you.
I'm in here shopping. So, like, that's literally like how I go to the store now, because I'm like, nah, I don't want to, don't talk to me. Cause,
and when that happens to me, it is always, are you watching me? Are you going to follow me? Where are you at? Now I'm over anxious because now I'm watching wherever you are and in relation to where I am.
So hold on. So let's as ladies, let's tell the motherfuckers, because there's 84 minute chat. These motherfuckers know, so we ain't talking to them. Let's tell motherfuckers when we want to be approached and where.
That's what I want to know. That's what we want to know. When is that okay?
There you go.
So you want to go first? You want me to go? Because I got a doctor.
You got it, sis. You got it.
Okay. So let me give you the Dr. Seuss presentation, because I like keeping things simple and digestible. Okay. So when approaching a woman, do not approach us in the supermarket, on a bus, on a train, in the rain, if you are in Spain. No, maybe not.
Maybe in Spain.
Do not approach.
The high probability times, you know, your best moments for agreement, okay, are going to be in your social rich environments. What do I mean by that? Environments that are intended for social interaction. Okay, a supermarket is not intended for social interaction. That's where we just go to buy fucking food. Okay, we're not coming in to shop for a husband or a boyfriend. And
We fell in love on the produce aisle.
No, we just want bell peppers, hot sauce, and maxi pads. Thank you so much. Okay. Okay.
The we gas found station. Love over a watermelon.
The gas station. We got some shit to put in to get to where the fuck we need to go. It ain't shit to do with you. Please don't. That shit's dangerous and flammables are involved. Don't do that.
So,
it was don't hurt nobody is what I got told at the grocery store.
At the bank. Okay, you just let's just keep going. Okay, so all of the regular everythings that motherfuckers do just to live life, those are not social, you know, rich things, obligations. So
you know, guys, listen to her. Listen to her, because she's making a lot of sense, because in the normal setting, i.e. gas station, grocery store, Target, Walmart, Publix, etc. That's the furthest thing from our mind, because we got X number of things to do and a small amount of time to do it. So timing is everything. Now we in the club, we hanging out at the library, we at the museum, we at the aquarium, we at the zoo, we at Disney World. I'm a little bit more susceptible to holler back at you, but when I'm in my
mission,
my Adidas and my hair pulled up, and I'm looking like I look all natural, you ain't on my mind, homeboy. So I'm gonna be a little bit more offended. This is good. We're the best TikTok on TikTok. We're the best live on TikTok.
I'm gonna chime in and help Mo out. Men, listen carefully. Women don't think with their dick. All right. So leave them be.
Eggplant.
They'll let you know.
And listen, I tell you what. And look, when we do think with it, baby.
You are funny. Mo.
When we do, just go. Listen, it ain't even something that gets discussed in these forums because you won't never turn it down. So
you already see that y'all in my notes because we gonna go into overtime. We're going into overtime. So let us know, Mo. Do the same thing when you do want us. Give me a Dr. Seuss when you do want us. How do we know when you really want us, when you really into us? Because many of us miss it. How do we know when y'all really into us?
It's the eyes. It's the eyes. If I look at you dead in your face and I smile.
So wait. So you're going to get two versions of this, okay? Because Angel is your normal woman.
Normal. And that's in air quotes, y'all. That's air quotes.
I'm a different bitch. Okay, so she's more of what you will probably encounter generally. Okay, I'm
like, you love me, Mo. Come on now.
Mo say I ain't the one. Mo say I'm not the one.
No, I am the one, but baby, if I am the one, you better motherfucking be ready. Cause this is gonna be the ride of your life.
Wait, listen, I'm gonna make you an offer you can't refuse.
Okay. Listen, you gonna be homeboy in Harlem Nights. Hey, put your mother on the phone. Hey.
Yeah.
Hey, I ain't never coming home again.
I'm never coming home again. I am never coming home again. Coach India has taken some Zyrtec D. She can take some Claritin. She got some Pepto Bismol. She got an Alka-Seltzer Plus. She got a ginger ale, some Buffalo Rock. She ready to talk now. It's something on her mind. Come on, Coach India.
Oh my goodness. Mo is so funny. Oh my gosh.
Well, Coach India, how does a man know you interested, Coach India?
Excuse me. I said, well, you know what? I said, I don't want to make the playing field smaller by saying, don't approach me here or there. I can meet someone in a, you know, at the grocery store, at the gym or wherever. I don't think it's where as much as their reaction. Their reaction is going to be their reaction regardless as to where you are. So if you approach me and I'm not interested, what is your reaction to me?
I got you.
Right? So that's really the issue. So if you have a reaction like you ain't all that all way anyway, whether we're at the grocery store, whether we're at the gym, whether I'm at a lounge, your reaction is what turns me off. Your reaction is what makes me choose the bear.
Okay. Go back to this, Mo, Angel, and Coach India. So, so let's say we in a non-social situation, i.e. the grocery store. How can a man get you to say, okay? How can a man get your attention when that's not even on your mind?
It's all in how you approach. Like if you come at me in a respectful way or don't come at me as, hey babe, hey shorty, I'm gonna tell you right now, Doc, you and I talked about this. You call me babe and we not together and we ain't been together, I'm gonna shut it down quick. That just irks me. That's me. So hey, maybe I'm not as normal as you think, Mo. But
hey Willie.
I'm just
we're going into overtime, y'all. This is blue table talk after dog.
I think this is a good variance. And I love the fact that you have normal women and I can add the spectrum because there's not enough credence or acknowledgement for different, you know, different people, right?
Right.
Yeah, so for me, in the way spectrum hyperfixation works, when I'm in a non-social zone,
okay,
that's it.
Okay. Okay.
You could be The Rock. You could be Morris Chestnut. You could be, I don't give a fuck.
Denzel.
I'm in the grocery store. If you standing in front of the ground beef and I'm there to get ground beef,
okay. You in the way.
Listen, you in the way.
Defenses, that was fucked up that she won the Oscar for Training Day. Move to the left. I need ground beef.
I need sirloin. I need 80% lean, 20% fat.
Oh no, baby. If I see Morris Chestnut and he's standing in front of the ground beef, baby, turn around. Let's talk.
What you got going on with that ground beef? Watch it, Coach.
What we having with that? Who's cooking?
What's for dessert? You know what's funny though? I have had multiple situations where I've seen men celebrities, black men celebrities, and I've been with friends and they're like, oh my God, and I'm like, bitch, it's the airport. That motherfucker's trying to go.
Let me get Dr. Taylor up here. Dr. Taylor, Mo, you got Dr. Taylor laughing.
I worked in the film industry, so I can tell you.
Wait, hold up. Is this JT or is this a different?
No, this Matt. This Dr. Matt Taylor.
Oh.
Yeah, you got him laughing. I got to get him on the hot seat with India. Yeah, I thought. I didn't.
You done bumped India out.
All right, let me get India back on. Come on. Hey, Dr. Taylor, you laughing, man? What's going on?
this is good. this is very interesting. I'm very interested to know Mo's perspective. Mo's at the meat counter. Let's stay at the beef.
We're gonna stay at the beef. Look at Mo.
Let's stay at the beef.
Okay.
I'm getting the 80-20 or the 70-30, whatever you like, right? Mo, he's from the first appearance, he's it. He's everything. What's your approach? Because you also deserve that liberty.
I'm making lasagna tonight.
Okay.
I actually prefer 85-15.
Okay.
Give me 2.5 pounds. Yeah, go ahead and wrap it up. Move to the left. I'm here for ground beef. What? See?
No. He's saying, and then the young man, he sees you're making. He sees the ragu. He sees the lasagna shells. He sees the ricotta cheese. He's got garlic bread. He's got a tiramisu. He said, what are you making tonight? Looks like that's the making of lasagna. He trying to open the door. And what you going to say after that?
You in the way. She's time and place.
Yeah.
You hyper-focused.
Yeah, I'm like, autism. It started on it in an hour. Because
I
got other shit to do.
Let me tell you why I've gone there. Why I'm going there. Because I think women miss out on opportunities because of who people say or think they may be. I'll give you an example of what everybody, like, she's this or she's that, she's a gold digger, she's this. But don't you have also isn't it okay for you to also say what you like and what you want?
Right.
She just did. She does not want to be bothered when she's going to get ground beef.
But to that point, though, I don't know your perspective now.
Yeah, now I'm talking about a perspective without you being judged, because I'm team female. I'm team female.
You've got daughters.
So yeah. So what I'm saying is,
okay. Wait. Hold on. Two ticks. Okay. So it's a female thing.
Sure.
I have a slight issue with that. Let me tell you how I receive female, just to give you feedback real quick.
Help me.
Female is a species level designator. Okay. You have a female frog, a female dog, a female cow, what have you. Okay. A female human is a woman. So when you call
Makes
me
sense.
A female and not a woman, you're stripping me of my humanity.
I accept that.
I received that. That's a good point. That's a good point, Mo.
Absolutely.
So won't woman has been judged, misdiagnosed, misjudged over and over and over again. So what I'm saying to you is, don't deny yourself of what you like because of what someone else may think or say about you. Because we are champions, we are heroes when men say, hey, when we jump in there and this is what we like and we say it, it's like, oh man, you went for that. Or you know, but when you do it, you look at it in a different way, and I don't think that's right.
So I don't know your context correctly. So are you meaning when I'm shutting down the attempt, or
no, you may like what you see, and the reason why you don't say anything is because of how you may be looked at.
No, I think Dr. Taylor, I think her point is she's not even concerned, because she's super focused on what she's doing in the grocery store. So her radar is totally off.
No, actually, it's even further than that. And I don't know if you were here when I was explaining before, but I'm on the autism spectrum.
Okay.
And so I have a huge amount of social awkwardness, and social cues are a huge blind spot for me. So.
Okay.
People, and then recognizing that kind of interaction, you know, so subtle cue. No, you got, listen, you got to point it, and you got to draw it, and you got to connect it.
Thank you, Dr. Taylor. I love y'all.
Email Coach me a India, PowerPoint at the drop close y'all of off. Order for me to get it. So. It's a little bit different way. That's why I said that, you know, Coach Angel being the normal woman.
Okay. Thank you for that, Coach. Well, listen, we got two men.
Hey, Clue Man, how you doing, bro?
Two men on the hot seat.
Good. How you doing?
We at Apple Dog. We're gonna go a few more minutes. Clue Man, what you got to say?
Hey, wait, let me bring a man. Clue Man, we're mutuals. I'm gonna bring a man. Clue Man, y'all.
Hey, long time no see, Sneaky.
Yes, sir.
Why does Clue Man look like Yellow's brother?
What?
I'm sorry. Okay.
What?
Never mind. I'm sorry.
Yellow, you look like a very paler version of a friend of ours.
Well, you know, here's something funny, because you guys are talking a little bit about attraction on one side or the other. And I got to say, I have had so many people in my life tell me, gosh, you look just like somebody I went to school with, or you look just like somebody I know. And I'm thinking to myself, I must be the most average looking motherfucker on the planet, because everybody says I look like somebody they know. I'm like, I got doppelgangers all over the freaking country, apparently.
Hey, wait a minute, Clue Man, or the total opposite. Or the total opposite. Right. It's sort of like you're the universal donor. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
The opposite. Everybody wants you.
Yeah. How can I be unanimous and anonymous at the same time is what I'm asking.
You're the old positive of faces.
I like, well, Clue Man, real quick. Clue Man, you got 5 minutes on the hot seat. What's your take on... I love the way Mo put it, the thought-provoking question, if you were stuck in the woods, would you rather be stuck with a bear or a man? It's a very hypothetical question. What's your take on what we've been talking about tonight?
Well, I've been thinking a lot about it since I first heard it, and being a former family therapist and working with troubled teens most of my life, I got to say that a lot of really bad men have had a huge impact on, you know, women and young girl. You know, it's, if you look at the numbers statistically, especially with like spousal abuse and all that stuff, it's off the charts. It's not happening. There was one time when I was in the Air Force as a security policeman before I got in the Army, that I got sent over to the ER to take a report on spouse abuse. That's what they told me over the radio. Go to the ER, take a report from a victim on spouse abuse. So I go over there. I'm looking around for a woman, because you know, 95% of spousal abuse is man against woman. Well, I see this skinny ass little guy all beat up in the ER, and they brought me in, and his wife had kicked the shit out of me. But so that was like once. And then all the other times I went to a domestic disturbance, you know, as a civilian cop and as a military cop, it was always the man, you know, beating on the woman. But I think that I mentioned in the comments, there is some primal evolutionary stuff going on. You know, we've only been seeing women as equals in the last maybe three generations. I mean, I've raised my son to be respectful towards women. I was raised by my dad to be respectful toward women. I was raised by a strong mom, a strong woman, and a respectful man. And so I feel like when I hear that question, I think the reason why a lot of the men are losing their minds over the question, I'm talking like a lot of these guys – well, they're self-proclaimed alphas, number one. They're these guys that if they'd be lucky to get a woman to talk to them, let alone go on a date with them. Right. So there's some bitterness there. But I also think on a primal level that the evolution that is women, equal rights for women. There's also an evolution happening for men. Like, we need to evolve as well, because 150, 200 years ago, women were seen as property. And, you know, they didn't even have the right to have a credit card in their own name till 50 years ago. So, I mean, yeah, so there's a lot of stuff going on, at least from a therapeutic standpoint, you know, and I'm not discounting the fact that there's one out of four women have been essayed or had some kind of serious thing happen to them, either from a family member or incidentally, I didn't put this on just because I was going to be on your live. I was actually over on Facts. I was actually over on Facts Still Matters live, and I was scrolling, and I thought, you know, I was bored with the comment, what they were talking about on Facts, and I got over here and I'm like, all right, listen, I saw Sneaky and I hadn't seen him in a while. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to listen in on these guys. And then Mo was making me like spray Sprite out my nose.
Clue Man, what are you doing on Wednesday nights at 8 o'clock Eastern? What are you doing, Clue Man?
I guess I'm hanging with you guys.
There you go.
Sneaky, what say ye? What say ye, Sneaky? We want to add him to our...
Make the motion.
I move that we add Clue Man to our regular lineup on Wednesday nights at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
I third it.
It has been moved and
properly. Thank you. Appreciate it.
All in favor say aye. Opposed by the same sign. Clue Man, welcome to the crew.
Thank you. So just to follow up, Dr. Sims... Just to follow up, Dr. Sims, go ahead, Mo, what do you got?
I'm going to tell you the swear for me, the judge that got the vote for me. Facts.
Facts.
Okay, that's my guy. That's my guy. If you rock with facts, you go with me.
Look, he's not Clue Man for nothing.
He's been talking about...
Dr. Sims, you can't put Clue... and Yella on the same road. Okay, never mind.
Welcome aboard, my friend. Welcome aboard.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Nice to have you, man. You're looking good, man. And you're going to fit right in, and you can come to the cookout.
All right, good. Yeah, that's the thing. I try to tell people, you know, my page on TikTok is I – only talk about the stuff that your parents told you never talk about in mixed company and out in public: politics, religion, and economics. So those are my three topics. And I've said all along that what's going on in our country right now is I can't invite a Republican to my barbecue anymore. I mean, it used to be when they were for Bush and I was for Clinton, we could still be buddies and come over and watch the Seahawks game or some shit, but not anymore.
Yeah.
This is some radicalized ideology bullshit going on right now.
It's crazy. Okay, before you go, and we're about to give last comment, before you go, somebody just said you got some pipes. So you can sing. If you can sing, give us something tonight. Give us
something. All right. Just a second. Let me channel somebody. Baby, lock the door and turn the lights down low.
Tell it,
put some music on that's soft and slow. Baby, we ain't got no place to go. I hope you understand. I've been thinking about this all day long.
All right.
Never felt a feeling quite this strong. I can't believe how much it turns me on just to be your man.
There you go. That's the guy to put it together. All right.
Thanks, man.
Next week, Clue.
See you guys.
Next week, Clue.
Thanks for coming, brother.
All right, Mo, Sneak, and then Angel. Mo, give us your last thoughts, man. We went into overtime tonight.
Hold on, hold on. Listen, that's uncanny. He's got the deep voice too. I don't know.
That's yellow. He just pouted up.
We love you too, man.
Not all fair skin.
Just kidding.
No, he and yellow got to be in the panel at the same time. I know, right?
I'm so excited. Our numbers are growing. Thank you, everybody, for tonight. We had this. This could have went so many different directions, but you see how civilized we are. You see how intellectually we talk. We bring out facts. We talk facts. We had a personal testimony from Coach Angel. And this is how we rock and roll every week. We are the best live on TikTok, hands down. Mo, Sneak, and then Coach Angel. We got to get out of here. Come on.
So out of this, and because May is Mental Health Month, Dr. Sims, as a great life and relationship coach, and me as a wonderful mental health patient with multiple diagnoses, not by this doctor, but multiple others, certified, verified on the spectrum, bipolar, medicated, but doing great and working through strategies in multiple layers of my life. The thing I love about this forum is that you are getting to hear multiple layers and multiple complexities of how different viewpoints and different aspects of the same demographic present. So I, being on the spectrum, as a woman can tell you, and then Coach Angel can tell you as a, what we call, what I love to call neurotypical.
Okay. I have a little ADHD myself.
Oh, damn, you know, real spicy too. Hey, listen. But the wonderful thing about it in hearing and adding those layers is that you're starting to peel back and understand the complexities, and that you cannot just generically label. You can't just put stereotypes on people. You can't just have unilateral expectations based on a characteristic that you ascribe rather than you observe and that you take in, right? So that's why you should keep coming back every Wednesday at 7 p.m. Central Standard Time for a Blue Table Talk with Dr. Susan and all of us. We'll be here. You come on down.
Thank you, Mo. We appreciate you, Mo.
Love you, Mo.
Hey, Sneaky, how Short Round doing?
Oh, Short Round got some shots the day before yesterday, and it took it like a champ. Didn't cry or anything, but yesterday and today he's sore. So he walk around like a little young old man. But he's doing good. He's doing all right.
He's a weeble.
Final thoughts. Final thoughts is I reiterate what Mo says. This is the best, and you, Dr. Sims, this is the best talk show on TikTok. You notice that we talk to each other, not at each other. We don't scream over each other. Okay. Everyone has their ideas. Everyone expresses those ideas. We either accept them or don't accept them, but not accept them. We either agree or disagree, but we accept them. Okay. Yeah, I look forward to Wednesdays. You guys help me through sometimes in some of my tougher moments, and you open my eyes on a lot of other things as well. I appreciate you. I'm glad that Clue Man is with us now, and I'll see you guys next week.
That's good. I need to duet with Doc Sims and Clue Man.
Hey,
I know, right?
Hey, listen, go ahead and spec out that new boat you're going to get, because I want to go fishing when I come to Raleigh.
I'll see what I can do.
Love you,
Sims. All right, see you next
week. Take care. All right.
We just collectively want to thank you for your testimony. You substantiated the fact. And the hypothetical question was basically just that. It was hypothetical, but it's a real thing for you guys. It's a real thing for you guys to be. Coach India said it well. You have to be aware of your surroundings at all times. You know,
head on swivel.
You know, but tell everybody, if they're looking for a coach with your expertise, how can they get in touch with Coach Angel?
You can get in touch with me at amarie0123@mail.com, not Gmail. It's at mail.com. So you can email me or you can DM me, and you can find my self guided journal on Amazon. It's actually on sale for like $23 or something right now. I got a special going on. But yes, just reach out to me. Doc obviously is amazing. He was my life coach. He's the one who trained me to be a life coach. So if you would prefer a man, he's amazing. Trust me, I fuss at him every week. I need more time with you.
And like, you know, I tell mama, I have to work sometime.
But yeah, so just if you prefer a female, a woman, sorry, Mo, a woman, then reach out to me. But yeah, other than that, it's all good.
All right, and congratulations on having those A's in your class.
Oh, Lord. My brain is mush, I'm telling you. But thank you to everybody. I'm happy to share my story. It is going to be part of a book. It is a long coming book. I've been working on it for years. But you really, in order to tell a story like that of how things became and how they are and why you are the way you are, it causes you to have to really dig deep. And so there are other folks involved, and out of protection per se, not that they were assailants per se or predators, but individuals, there's other individuals' lives that was impacted as well. So in order to protect them, I have slow rolled this quite a bit. But if it helps somebody else to feel comfortable about telling their own story, 'cause we all have one, so be it. I don't mind sharing mine if it's gonna help.
Amen. Well, you tell those boys to behave, and y'all have a good weekend, and we'll see y'all next week, all right?
All right. Love you guys.
Hey guys, tonight's show was off the chain. Thank you for my moderators. My moderators were busy keeping everybody engaged tonight. We had a lot of questions. If you put a question out, we didn't see it, repost it. You can send us an email at thebluetabletalkformen@gmail.com. We are fielding questions. If you have a question for us, we'll field it. The panel will talk about it. A gentleman told me a few weeks ago, we had a heated conversation, and I was making sure everybody was heard. And one of the gentlemen in the chat said, "Dr. Sims, you're a great moderator." Because a lot of times I leave my comments to the end if I want to say anything extra, but this is not about me. It's about our panel. And I just saw the Asian Saban come in, my golfing buddy. What's up, Asian Saban? He's a fellow Cowboy fan like me. Hey, Mickey. But let me tell you how I feel tonight. I love my wife. I love my mother. I love my niece. I love my nieces. I love my sisters. I love all my friends. I love every female that's in my life. I love them. My goddaughters, my grandbabies, etc. I'm like Clue Man. I'm like Sneaky. We were brought up to respect women. And it leads into my message. Hey, Miss Dixon, it leads me to my sermon for Sunday. I've been doing a series on standing on business. And one of the things I'm going to talk about Sunday is Matthew chapter 7, verse 12. It's the golden rule. And it says, do unto others, right, Clue Man, do unto others as you will have them do unto you. Guys, ladies, if you want respect, you have to give respect. You want kindness, you have to be kind. You're going to reap what you sow. You can't get peace. You can't get chaos. You can't get peace out of chaos. All right? You have to treat others like you want to be treated. And like Mo said, if I can help one person at a time, one person, let's be a committee of one. I love what Mo said. It's not all men. We're not talking about all men, but it can be any man. I said tonight in Bible study, and talking about Isaac and Jacob deceiving his father to get Esau's blessing. And he couldn't fathom his wife and his son would deceive him. So he felt something was different, but he didn't act on it. And I said this, hey, Coco, I said this, and that's for this whole bear man conversation. Don't put it past anybody to do anything. At the end of the day, we're selfish. Hey, Colleen, we're selfish. We're greedy. We always want it our way. And so when you're dealing with people, you got to take in the fact that they're not out for your best interest. And you have to be on your guard. I love people. So I give everybody benefit of the doubt. And then some may think it's being simple or whatever. But people are my widget. I love people. I'm a pastor. I'm a coach. I'm an author. I'm a pro speaker, etc. So I love people. People are my widget. And I know people are a trip. I know that. But at the end of the day, I see beyond all that. I know at the core, you just crying out and you ain't at peace. I talked about Esau tonight. That Bible study was so good. Anyway, DrWalterSims.tv. That Bible study was so good. Esau had a chip on his shoulder. He was mad and angry. Some people in this chat right now. You can't get along with nobody, but I still got mad love for you. You can't get along with yourself. You go to bed wrestling with yourself. Wake up wrestling. You're not at peace. So if you're not at peace with yourself, you're going to be cantankerous with everybody else. And what I want for you is to be at peace. And for those that have given up on relationship, I was in a live the other day, and this Don P. Sounds. Well, I was in another young lady's live, and she was talking about marriage and everything. She's married, and she's advocating, just be feminine and all that. And somebody said, well, advocate being in a marriage. Advocate being in a relationship. And I kind of chuckled. I said, well, advocate being single, you know? It's like Coke Pepsi, you know? I love my relationships. I love my relationship. I love my wife. And she loves me. All right? And what I want for you tonight is to be at peace. Whatever that looks like for you. But I know what that looks like. I pray for you. If you're not at peace tonight, I pray for you. Because I'm telling you, as we get older, and I teach this to my clients, as we get older, you guard your peace. My wife and I was talking about this over the holidays. I mean, we don't have much. I said, well, why are people jealous of us? And the Lord quickened my spirit. They are jealous of your peace. We don't walk around complaining all the time, whining about what we ain't got or nothing like that. We are just happy. Thank God that God allowed us to find each other. We are happy. Mama be laughing at us. Mama, we just happy. I tell people about as happy as a pig in wet mud. Hello, somebody. Y'all got me hyped tonight. Y'all got me hyped tonight. This is the best live on TikTok. We ain't about no drama. We ain't fussing and fighting. We ain't trying to outshine each other. We just be. We like a band of superheroes. All right? But I love every one of you. And remember, if you stay high on life, life's going to stay high on you. And I want you, if you don't have peace tonight, you need to do something to change that. I teach my class, if you want that needle to move in your life, you got to do something. If you're not at peace tonight, I challenge you tonight. It's a sad existence not to be at peace. I don't care what you do. You're not happy with anything. I don't care what you do. Just ain't happy. I challenge you tonight. You got to deal with that. And so I hope you learned something tonight. Thank you for being here. Thank you for all our new followers. Thank you for our regulars. Thank you for all the love tonight. Thank you for all the gifts. We appreciate everybody. Thank you for the 15,000 hearts tonight. Thank you for staying with us and staying engaged with us tonight. Oh, we're going to have another topic next week. If you got a question for us, shoot me. Just follow me or DM me or send us an email at thebluetabletalkformen@gmail.com. And remember again, thanks everybody for being here. And remember, if you stay high on life, life's going to stay high on you.